Hello everyone, welcome back to another edition of Sid's Reviews. My name is Dale, and today it's all about the Klipsch R-15PM powered monitor speakers. Let's get into it. Before I get to the details about these speakers and my thoughts on them, I thought I might explain to you guys what exactly powered monitors are, because let's face it, some people just aren't quite sure what the terminology is. So there's passive speakers, which are pretty much your regular speakers, which everyone knows, that plugs into the back of either an amp or a receiver in there. And then there's these type of speakers. So these ones here actually have their own amp inside it on one side here. The amp is inside here, and you plug it in at the back, and then you plug it directly into the wall. So there's no need for a receiver or an amp for it. Everything is in the speaker here, and the connections are in the back, and I'll spin them around right away and show you exactly what all the connections and stuff look like. But yeah, that's the difference here between powered monitors and passive speakers. So why would anyone want this? Well, there's a number of reasons. One, there's space saving, obviously. So everything is incorporated into here. So this is all you need. You plug that in and you put them on some stands and you're pretty much ready to go. They're very portable. You can bring them anywhere. They're good for two-channel listening beside a TV. As for external speakers, much better than the ones usually in a TV. And also for near field listening. So if you have a computer monitor and you want some nice sound beside it, hey, these are perfect to put right beside there. They come with a lot of features and they sound really good too. So anyway, let's get into the detail and review of this. And quickly, I'll turn it around and show you all the connections coming right up. Okay, everyone. So here is the back of the Klipsch model R-15PM powered monitor speaker. So let's check out what we have here. First of all, this is the main speaker with the amplifier in it and obviously all the connections. And then this speaker here is just a regular connection, so there's no amp in here. So you connect it by just regular speaker wire. So there's nice binding posts here. Banana plugs can get you. And the Klipsch also comes with everything as well. So all the wires that you need to hook it up and everything, they're all included into here. So let's start off over here. Now these two input here is actually very interesting. So it doubles as an line input that you'd put in there, or it would also be a phono input. So if you have a record player, it has its own phono input in there. So you just have the record player, hook it right up. There's the ground right there. And then away you go. You could have your own record player set up already like that. There's also an auxiliary plug in here for like a headphone type plug. There's a subwoofer input as well. So yes, you can hook up a subwoofer to this as well, which we'll talk about later. Your volume source button at the back of the speaker, so that controls the digital volume, and that'll switch. You press it in to switch all the sources between Bluetooth and USB and optical. Here you have two digital inputs, so you have your Toslink optical input and also USB audio to hook up to a PC computer, the power input switch, and also obviously the plug input on there. So that's about it. A lot of options to hook up, and now let's turn around and get to the review. Yeah, I forgot to mention as well here, there's also a nice handy Klipsch remote control for this unit as well. So you could operate everything via remote control. All the settings are on there for everything that you need, including subwoofer adjustments and input adjustments, everything like that. It's just a small remote, very, you know, it's plastic, it's cheap, but it definitely does the job. So that's great that they include that. Okay, so what do you get now with these Klipsch power monitored speakers? Well, as you can see, it's a two-way design with a nice horn tweeter on them. And the woofer is a nice copper woofer. I believe they're 5 1/4 inch in diameter. And one thing to mention is there's no grills on these speakers at all. There's no way to cover them up. This is how they come, and they're always exposed. But you know what? I kind of like it that way. I really like the color of those woofers. I think they really make these speakers pop anyway. Now, these speakers came out in 2015, I believe, and since then, I believe they've been replaced with like the RP51, there's an RP41, I believe, power monitor speakers, and it's pretty much the same specs from what I've seen on them, except there's a little bit more power in those other ones compared to this one. Now, speaking of power, this one is rated at 50 watts. I don't think it's 50 watts per channel. It doesn't really say. It's probably 25 watts per channel. But let me tell you something about the power of these. These things get loud, and I mean really loud. Like I haven't even tried to crank them up all the way. I kind of got scared of it. So believe me, if it's only 25 watts of power, they're dynamic enough that they could really come forward in that way. What I really love about these Klipsch speakers is just the options, like for connectivity to it. I mean, you don't want to buy something and then all of a sudden, you know, oh, I wish it had this feature. Oh, I wish it had this feature. Like, you know, if it doesn't have one thing or another, it's like you're spending like, you know, whatever it is, $300 or $500, $600 on a pair of monitor speakers. You want them to sound good and you want them to have enough connectivity and options for anything that you need. And this thing has that. It has, obviously, it has, if you're a turntable guy, it has that covered for you. It has Bluetooth in it. You could hook it up, you know, near field as a powered monitor, optical. You know, it has all the connections in the back here. And I don't think there's anything in here that it's really lacking in it. Okay, so what did these speakers sound like? Well, if you ever heard a Klipsch before, then you know what I'm talking about. You're going to get a very dynamic and lively sound. Everything's going to be coming a little bit forward, especially the treble and the vocals are going to be a little bit forward. It kind of sounds like you're at a rock concert with these things. It doesn't take much into the volume to really get these things going. And they sound really, really good and crisp, very crisp. The treble is going to be nice and bright and present. Not too bright, though. Not the harshness that you're thinking that you sometimes get with Klipsch sounds. These don't do that. But they are very forward. And the mid-range, you can hear voices very clearly on them. I like the mid-range on them. Now, bass is kind of where these things lacking. I'm not going to say it has no bass, but you do need to get the best out of them. I would hook up a subwoofer to it, and that's exactly what I do in my living room upstairs. So once you add a subwoofer to these speakers, I think then is the magic where you get that full range sound that will make for a really enjoyable listening experience with these speakers. No matter if you're using them for desktop or two channel or just beside your TV, your widescreen that you have upstairs, these speakers really got it into that. And let me tell you, it's a much better option than a soundbar would be. With the stereo design, obviously you get that separation that I don't think a soundbar could possibly emulate. And for near field, I think these things are fantastic for a two-channel option for your monitor, for your PC gaming. So with these speakers, I tried basically hooking it up to all the connections on them, and just let me go over a few of the connections on it. Now for the phono preamp on there, I did hook it up with my Riga turntable into these speakers straight up, turned on the phono input, and let me tell you, I was quite surprised with the sound coming out of it. You know, the speakers you know, had that signature sound, very dynamic, very lively into it, and the phono preamp in it is actually half decent. So I think it stood up really well, and you know, I really enjoyed my time listening to it with just my record player and these speakers on there. Bluetooth, once again, I was very surprised at the sound that came out of it. It wasn't thin or anything like that. It didn't lose any connectivities when I hooked it up with Bluetooth. It was a solid connection, and again, you know, it was good, it was punchy. It was a very enjoyable listen for Bluetooth through my iPhone and these speakers. CD player as well, I hooked it up with analog and the digital input in there, and they both sounded really good. Now the DAC in this thing, I would say, is good, like it's adequate in there. However, if you want even better sound out of these speakers, I suggest that you use an external DAC and hook it in between into these sets. I tried that out upstairs with my television, so at first I hooked up the optical directly into these speakers and listened to a few shows and a couple of movies with it, and it sounded very good, very good. But once I hooked it up, I just bought a Mahdi 3 DAC on there, and so I ran it from my TV optical to my Mahdi DAC, my shit DAC, and then auxiliary into the speakers in here. And then I noticed a bit more punch, I guess, to everything. The slam into the bass was a little bit better, I think. Vocals was a little bit better coming out of it, definitely a lot more clear. So if you want even better sound out of it, hook up an external DAC to it, and I think you'll really enjoy the results. But the stuff built in is no slouch either. It's still really good, one product solution, I believe, for a lot of people that they would really enjoy this. Okay, so now that you heard a lot of my thoughts on these speakers, I'm going to go over some of the pros and cons, I guess, just to kind of summarize it. So a pro, I mean, obviously you get that classic Klipsch sound that I think a lot of people enjoy, especially for something like this, you know, very forward presentation, dynamic, very powerful sound. I believe where, you know, it's a bit tilted up in the treble and the mid-range. So I think people, you know, really like that sound. I like how it has a lot of options in it. I like you could hook up a subwoofer to it. I like that it's good for, a record player, you know, get back into vinyl. A lot of people are getting, you know, just back into vinyl and they want a quick solution. You know, they have a record player and, you know, if you don't have a phono preamp, bang, this one has one in there. All you need is that, just hook it up right to it and you're on your way. The Bluetooth option, it's good for near field or just two channel listening. It's good if you want, you know, an option for a sound bar, you want some couple of speakers beside your TV, this thing is great to hook up to it. So it has a lot of connectivity, very good sound, and, you know, space saving. So, you know, you get power monitors, you plug it in, you don't need to match an amp for speakers, everything's kind of the solution in here, and the amp matches the speakers very well. So I think it's a really good solution that way. A couple of the cons, I guess. Well, a con would be that the lack of bass on it, I guess. So it does have a little bit of bass, but for me, I think for most people, you're going to want to put a subwoofer to it, especially if you're serious about, you know, just having a little bit more punch, a little bit more full range sound, I guess, with your speakers. I would suggest to put a subwoofer on it at least. And I guess another minus would be a little bit of the remote. I mean, I like that it has, you know, a lot of features on it and stuff, but some people might think it's a little bit flimsy and small and easy to lose and stuff like that. Some people just don't like the touch and feel of it. I don't mind it. I think it does what it's supposed to do, and it certainly has a lot of options on it, and I kind of like it, actually. Otherwise, you know, this is a great option for people, and I think I'm going to have my final thoughts right now, so be right back. Okay, so my final thoughts for these speakers is, I think for anyone who's looking for a simple solution, just for a couple of speakers, for quick sound, good sound, they want to have a lot of options to hook up different connectivities. They don't want to fool around with, you know, matching an amp to a speaker or anything like that. Hey, this thing is absolutely a superb option, in my opinion. The sound is very good, very dynamic. They do need a subwoofer to get full range sound, but to me, these speakers are a really good option for a lot of people. Now, availability, you could still buy these things on Amazon and eBay. I believe in Canada, you can get them for about $550 on Amazon. And eBay, I think you could pick them up for, you know, $300, $350 US type thing. So they still are available. I know Klipsch has upgraded this to an R51 line. But, you know, if you could find these things, I think they'd be a great option. Competition on these, I mean, who doesn't make power monitored speakers right anymore? I mean, you got the likes of SVS and Canto and Edifier and Swan and PSB. I mean, the list goes on and on. You got a lot of options for these things. But Klipsch is a very trusted name, obviously. They've been around the block, been around for a long time. People know their sound. People are familiar with them. I don't think anyone wouldn't know what the Klipsch is. And so, who knows, it'd probably be a good option maybe for you too, if you guys want a speaker with great sound and easy setup and lots of options. So that's it. What do you guys think of the review here on Sid's Reviews? Let me know in the comments and questions and comments below. Make sure you like and subscribe if you like my take on how I do reviews, and be on the lookout for the next exciting audio review here on Sid's Reviews. Thanks and take care.